hello everyone. For those who are new, I am Meg, and for those who are returning, welcome back. So today I wanted to talk about products that are new to the market or relatively new to the market and whether or not I'm going to purchase them. Now, as you guys know, I used to do like even a monthly anti-haul. I used to do shit lists and all that stuff, but you know what I was thinking, and this is inspired by Emily Noel. I watched her video with Jen Loves Reviews, and she said that the reason why she didn't do anti-hauls was because it was difficult for her to tell other people not to purchase certain makeup products when she hasn't actually tried them, which is true, and I admire her for that. And so I was thinking to myself, yeah, I probably will probably stick to just doing like these things that are new in the product, in the market. Am I interested in them? Why am I not gonna buy them? Why am I going to buy them? And see how that goes. Now, the other thing that I wanted to mention before anything else was that there are certain brands that will never be mentioned on my channel because I will never ever buy from those brands. No matter how tempted I am, it's just because I don't believe or I don't want to support the people behind those products. Like KKW, Kylie Cosmetics, Jeffree Star. And that's my personal choice. If you love them, then go ahead, spend your money however you want to. But I'm not gonna be spending my money on products that are from those certain brands, okay? There's a few other ones that are not at the top of my head at the moment, but you will know. Okay, so let's start off. I am on my Instagram and I'm looking at, because I'm following Trend Mood and Dupe That on Instagram. And here they've got Juvia's Place is coming out with liquid foundations. And I've heard so many good things about Juvia's Place, especially their eyeshadows. In fact, I'm tempted to purchase some, especially the Zulu palette that is their like colorful bright. But I'm also tempted to buy the BH Cosmetics Festival palette. So I am in between. I don't know which one to choose just yet. But I know I've tried BH Cosmetics before, but that was a long time ago when I was first doing YouTube and their products were not as great. However, I've heard that it's been reformulated and the reviews that I've seen about the Festival palette has been great. So I don't know. We will see. If I do decide to get a Juvia's Place palette, I might look into this foundation, although I do still have 5 foundations in my collection, so I probably will hold off and also just watch reviews of these before I dive into purchasing it. But the great thing about this is that they are saying that it will be a huge range of shades from the darkest complexions to the very light and pale complexion. So obviously I am in the middle, so that I'm sure will have something that would suit me. I also like supporting this like smaller brands anyway, so let's see what the reviews say, and if they're good then I might just do it. Okay. The next thing is that Hourglass is coming out with their, or has come out actually, of their The Veil collection with the Veil Translucent Setting Powder. I've seen a few videos on YouTube about this already, and it seems like it is a good product. Everyone is liking it so far. So, but with the price tag of this, I don't know if I would spend that much money on a setting powder. I like my RCMA Translucent Powder. It does the job for me. It makes me look poreless. So maybe if I won the lottery, I would consider it. Not that I am betting anyway. Here we go. OPV Beauty is dropping a line of glitter liners. These are $14 a piece, according to Dupe That. And there's a lot there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 20 shades. The swatches are not very impressive. They're quite patchy, actually, from what I'm seeing. I don't know. And I don't really feel the need to be putting on glitter eyeliner, especially because I work in a corporate environment. It's not really something that I could wear on a daily basis. Maybe if I was going to a festival, which I never go to. So this is a pass for me. I'm not really into glitter anyway, even with eyeshadow. I did order the Stila Ready Set Go, I think is what it's called, mini kits of their Magnificent Metals liquid shimmer shadows. I'm still yet to get that because I ordered from the States. My sister is sending that to me, so I'm sure everyone has already done a review by the time that it gets to me, but I will still do that. And that is probably going to be the extent of me putting glitter on my lids, especially because I wear contacts sometimes and I just don't want them dropping into my eye and blinding me. Okay, so definitely a pass on the OPV beauty glitter liners. Now, here we go. Marc Jacobs also came out with their new coconut collection with rose gold details, and it looks really pretty. I've never tried any Marc Jacobs eyeshadows, and I don't know, these aren't the ones that are calling my name. If, like, I know that he's got one that's got some sort of greens into the collection, and or the ones that with purples, those ones I'm interested in. I think they are the ones that come in the black packaging. This one comes in white, and I also have I don't really have a very good experience with white packaging because it usually gets really dirty. So I don't know, I'm gonna pass on this. But that bronzer, which has my name on it, the Omega bronzer, is calling my name. 104 Tintastic, but $50 for a bronzer. I know this is huge. I've seen pictures of this, and I've watched YouTube videos of beauty bloggers holding this up, and they are huge. They're almost like the size of their faces. I don't know. Maybe. I feel like I am obligated to buy it because it has the name Omega. Not that I have to buy everything that's Omega because I don't have the Omega watch, you know. But still, it looks nice. I just might. Marc Jacobs, I think, is available at Sephora here in Australia, so I might go in and just have a look first, and I'm going to be in the city on Monday. By the time you're watching this, that would mean yesterday for you guys, so I'm going to go ahead and swatch that and see if I like it, if it's actually a bronzer that's going to show up on my skin tone, and if it is, it might actually be going home with me. Alright, Makeup by Shayla has a collaboration with ColourPop Cosmetics, and the colors are nice, but they're not really unique to my collection. So I don't think I'll be buying this. The eyeshadows are the ones that are really calling my name. But like I said, they're not very unique to my collection. I do have some blues and pinks already, and I have a lot of warm colors. And I do have a few MAC eyeshadows that are more on the cooler toned side. So I think this is going to be a pass. Now for the lipsticks, I have heard mixed reviews of this lipstick formulation by ColourPop. Not many of the ones that I've, the YouTubers that I follow, actually like this. What do they call this? Luxe lipsticks? Yeah, not very many like them. And I don't really, I have quite a bit of lipsticks. I only have one set of lips, so I don't think I'll be buying this because the only shade that actually is calling my name there is Come On Sis. And that kind of actually looks like either Captive or Twig, which I have both from MAC. There you go. So I'm passing on that collection from Makeup by Shayla. ColourPop Cosmetics is coming up with so many stuff. They've got the Super Shock Foursome, which is a palette that's got four shades in it. But the colors, Walk the Vine, Heavy Petal, and what's the other one? Full Moon. They don't really look that different from each other. I don't know why it has to be three separate quads when they look pretty much the same. So not going to be buying that. They're all like warm neutrals, and I have all of these colors in my collection already. Essential Nudes Lip Trio. I have all the nudes that I can use at the moment, so maybe pass on that as well. Now, the cheek duos I am curious about. One in particular, the Thorn to be Wild, is something that I think would be my particular shade. It's got sort of like the dusky, not really dusky, but sort of terracotta shade and a darker champagne, almost, how would you describe that shade? Yeah, highlighter, maybe that one. And how much are those? It doesn't actually say on the Trend Mood post that I'm reading. But maybe those. Although, honestly, I don't need any more blushes. I've got an entire, like, I've got 12 MAC blush contouring highlight. I've got 2 Narcissist palettes. What else? And I've got individual blushes. So I'm, maybe not. MAC is coming out with the Aaliyah collection. I don't know when this is coming out here in Australia, but I do like that sort of magenta burgundy shade. No, not burgundy, sort of magenta purple shade that looks really nice. And that lipstick, that really dark lipstick, looks like dark wine. Looks really nice. Maybe I will. I do like my MAC shadows. I'm still waiting for the Patrick Star collection to drop here in Australia, and if it does, I'm going to swatch it. And I might end up getting the Me So Chic collection. I do like the blush and bronzer duo in there, and the eyeshadows are also quite nice. Let's see, what else? What else is coming out? Revlon is coming out with some kind of psychedelic Electric Shock Shoot the Moon collection. Different products with purple packaging, lipsticks, lip powder palette. Similar to what do you call that? NARS came out with. Glosses, jelly highlighters, not interested. They look like something from the 80s, which I was born in the 80s, but I just don't think they are something that I would wear. Okay, what do we got next? Lime Crime has finally showed us what is inside the palette that they came out with, which is the Venus 3 palette. I have all these shades, so I'm not gonna even prolong this and just say I'm not gonna get it. Okay. However, the Agent Carter collaboration with Besame, I like that. In case some of you are not familiar, because, I mean, my siblings are collectors of comic books, so I am quite familiar with these characters. Agent Carter, because I've heard some YouTubers say, I don't know who they are, I've watched the Avengers movies, and who is she? Agent Carter is the lady that Captain America fell in love with before he was cryogenically frozen, okay? And she passed away before he woke up. That's Agent Carter, okay? And the shades in here, that sort of like moss green shade, they're not that unique to my collection. That green is probably the only one that I am interested in. And because of that, I don't think I will get this. Oh, however, it looks really nice and the packaging is so cute. It's like a passport. We'll see. I will think about it. But most likely not. Have I even decided on whether I would get anything? I don't know. Oh, the Wet n Wild Flights of Fancy. They came out with a huge collection with 4 lip products, 2 eyeliners, a primer water, 3 highlights, blushes, and 3 eyeshadow palettes. I'm not gonna get the whole collection because honestly, I don't need it. But that palette with the green and purple is calling my name, and I probably will try to get that. If there is an online store that sells Wet n Wild here in Australia, I'm gonna try and get that, as well as that really pink blush. And if the liquid lipsticks or the lip gloss are anything like, oh no, they're just lip glosses, not like the liquid catsuit. If they were anything like the liquid catsuit, I would get one of those as well. But it doesn't seem so, it just says lip gloss. Huda Beauty is coming out with another one of, or another two of their Obsession palettes. One is called Gemstone Obsession and the other one is Coral Obsession. And I have no interest in the Coral Obsession, but the Gemstone Obsession is looking really nice. Although, looking at the swatches, they're all shimmery. Not that I mind the shimmery, but I don't think that the swatches give justice to the color on the pans. Maybe it's the lighting, I don't know. But it's not very impressive. I will have to wait for this to drop at the Sephora here in Australia and swatch them in person and see. These are really tiny though, like, and they're like $40 here in Australia. But let's see, I'll swatch it, and if I like it, you'll probably see it in a haul. Because that gemstone, yeah, okay. Here, Viseart is actually coming out with a new palette, and they are also repackaging their palettes that are in currently in their collection into magnetic palettes so that you can actually mix and match them. But they are coming out with another palette that's got a little bit of purples and is that teal? In the picture it looks like it's teal, but and on the swatches looks like it's teal. So yeah, they're coming out with another one called the eyeshadow palette Cool Matte 2. Interesting. Now, there was a Viseart, what do you call that, retailer here in Australia before, but I don't know if they're still selling because we don't have any more eye mats here. There was an eye mats last year, but this year they're not going to have an eye mats. I was really disappointed. I hope they will be at the Sydney Beauty Expo, because if they are, I am going to swatch these, and if I like them, I'm going to buy them. However, Viseart has also come out with another Petite Pro. I think this is the third one that they've come out with, the ones that come with the green shades. And you know green's my favorite color, so you're probably gonna see me order that. Now, MAC has finally come out with a collection that I am interested in, other than the Patrick Star collection. This is their MAC Mirage Noir. And wow, duochrome packaging, the mother of pearl, pearly texture with matte finish. I don't know what that is, but it looks like it is a sort of bronzer blush. It's gorgeous. I want to get it. I have one of the bronzers that they're coming out with, which is Delphic. The other one is Golden Rinse. Not interested in that. Delphic, I do like. And then they have some eyeshadow singles that are coming off. Dust Off, Sunspeck, Slow As You Glow, and Suntan and Retreat. Suntan and Retreat just looks like their blue-brown eyeshadow, so I'm not really keen on that. And also none of the lipsticks call out to me. But that powder that looks like a blush is gorgeous. And I think I'm gonna pick that up. Not to mention the packaging is awesome too. Makeup Geek, this is gonna be the last one. Makeup Geek has come out with their Power Pigment. I've tried some of the Makeup Geek eyeshadows. I think they were overhyped in the past. When all of these big YouTubers were talking about them, they're okay. Okay, they're not the best eyeshadows I've tried. But this Power Pigments, I've seen the video of Marlena, and I've seen the swatches as well. They are gorgeous. They will be sold individually, actually. That was going to be my next question. If they are going to be sold individually, because they are, I probably will pick up some of the shades, like that sort of periwinkle shade, some of the greens maybe. I'll have to have a look at what I have in my Inglot collection, because I do have like all the rainbow, well not all the rainbow, but most of the rainbow shades of Inglot, and that covers most of these shades. But I just want to try the formula, so we will see. I'm curious about that. Right. So those are things that caught my eye that's coming out or is probably already out in the market, and only a few of them are going into my wish list. Most of them are not going to be something that I would buy. So, yeah. Let me know, what has caught your attention recently in the most recent releases? Are you buying anything? You know, from the last one that I've done, I think the only one that I actually bought was the Vlada Smashbox collaboration of the Rose Mantic Petal Metal highlighter. That's still on its way here to Australia. My sister still has it. So I know there's already tons of reviews out there. Let me know if you want me to talk about that. I only bought one item from that collection. I just really wanted that one. And I didn't think I needed any other ones anyway, because I do have a collection that I am still trying to use up. So there you go. Yeah, so let me know. I keep rambling and going on tangents. But yeah, let me know what recently has caught your eye, and are you going to be purchasing them? That's it. I'll see you all in the next video. Subscribe if you haven't already, and click on that notification bell so that you know when I do upload. I usually upload Sundays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays.